Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. This is Crazy Kitsune Gaming with yet another episode of the Garden Warfare 2 Zombie Campaign Walkthrough. And today we are going to be moving on to Super Brainz missions. Although I've also realized something, I don't think I have any more zombie characters to explain, unless I've missed somebody. Well, there is actually one other zombie character technically in the roster, but honestly, he is so late game to unlock that you probably won't have him while you're still doing the campaign, so yeah, don't really feel much of a need to. So, Super Brainz missions. These are the ones I would recommend doing next. They are sort of the intermediate difficulty between Pirate and Imp. Pretty interesting little room he's got here. Now then, Super Brainz. I would like to talk to you if I could not get caught on strange bits of geometry. Alright then, hello there. Oh right, yeah, you're not Super Brainz, you're technically Super Duper Brainz. Alright then, so this is an ops mission, so we'll take it down to normal, and then we'll take it back up to hard for when we get to the other two. So, Special Ops. Prove your worth to Super Duper Brainz by defending a tombstone on Boney Island. Okay then. Hey, you caught me at a great time! I just put the final coat of glaze on my heroic hairdo! If you want to ride with the awesomeness, you'll need to prove you've got what it takes. Also, probably work on your physique a bit. Scram! To the island of Boney! Show those weeds you mean Brainz business! Brainz! Hey, I mean, it's better dialogue than the last two zombies that we worked for. So then, Boney Island. Prove your worth to Super Duper Brainz by defending a tombstone on Boney Island. Yeah, that is, tis what we hope to do today. So, yeah, could be going in with Foot Soldier, because, you know, he has the Stink Cloud, the Jetpack, the ZPG, all the usual BS McGubbin gadgets. Alright then. This island wind is messing up my hair! Oh no, I feel so bad for you. Raise that tombstone, sidekick applicant! I'll get to it once we have some help. Do I want to bring an imp? Imps just die so easy in this mode, but you know what? We'll bring an imp, just so we can say that we've done it. Now let's also bring a scientist for some healing. And, you know, it's a Super Brainz mission, let's bring in a Super Brainz. Why not? Lots of damage, some healing, one who's probably just gonna die unless he has his mech, and even when he has the mech, he uses it at the worst possible times. It's a perfect team. It's a foolproof plan. Alright then, tombstone raised. Let's get a couple bots. Prepare for battling! Plants are afoot! So then, one of the bots, Mr. Electro, he is a medium-range electric bot. Workplace safety was never Mr. Electro's thing. Mr. Electro just wants to dance, and also shoot plants with lightning at medium range. He is very good for close-range defense on graveyards, especially against those large crowds of weeds, because he has that lightning effect that will actually chain across multiple targets. Maybe something like a Misty Freezy would help down here. Clobber Sandwich, I like your style. Oh, my style of, you know, actually defending it with somewhat medium-range defenders. I mean, yeah, it's a good strategy. Did I just fail that because of a bone? Okay. Everything is against me in this world, it seems. Hello there, weeds. I would like to talk to your supervisor about your presence here. It is not allowed. Okay, it was a group of weeds. You don't have to use missile madness. I mean, stop, Z-Mac. They're already dead. That was not your kill. I put, like, 10 shots into him. And he just comes up with the laser and just says, yeah, no, no, this was definitely my kill. Definitely all the credit belongs to the Z-Mac. Oh, he gets most kills, too? Really? We can't let this happen. Alright, another group of plants incoming. Should probably go about dealing with them. Oh, and we have fire peas. Oh, yay. Fire splash damage going around and hitting everybody. Let's just get that out of the house, shall we? Thank you. Oh, and thank you too, scientist. Okay. So it looks like a group has spawned inside the volcano. We should address that. How do we want to address that? ZPG, perhaps. Nope, that actually hit the flagweed. Okay. That was one of the weirdest bean bombs, and you know what? It actually worked. That weird little bean bomb worked because Super Brainz just charged in before thinking. Okay. Weed, where are you going? Oh, he was going off to die to Mr. Electro, okay. Because apparently dying to a foot soldier is actually just so much worse. I mean, yeah. Kinda. Thing is, Mr. Electro, that's an electrocution death. I don't know. I feel like I'd rather get shot with Z1 assault blasters. I'm not sure. Is your spandex flame resistant? I don't actually have a spandex, unfortunately. I don't even have a yellow spandex. It's such a tragedy. Okay, that's another fire pea. And that's me using smoke grenade and jumping on out of here. Because there's actually, yep, two of them over there. And a fire cactus in the distance. No. I'd rather not deal with it. Come here. Get over here. Take your penance. Alright then. There is yet another group coming. Oh, the fire peas, they're just chucking them out like vending machines. Stop! Oh wow, okay, that was an interesting gravity grenade. It pulled him down. Usually gravity grenade ends up pulling you up. Alright then, another perfect wave. Has the graveyard actually gotten hit yet? Not 100% sure it has. Okay then. Wave 4 coming in real quick. Okay, both spawning in the volcano cave. But they're both real far apart. Let me deal with this side this time. Maybe a good choice since there's a cactus over here. Hey there, cactus. Let me try jump-shotting you. I can't even jump-shot an AI. I love that. Hey there, pumpkin head. Okay, the potato mine despawned. Good. Sometimes they don't. Like, I know in private play, if a AI cactus drops a potato mine, it will actually stay there. But at least in the backyard and in garden and graveyard ops, they will actually disappear should that AI cactus die. Since, you know, they really have no way of respawning, they just spawn in a completely new one. So the potato mines will actually just despawn with them. You didn't need to turbo twist. What are you really doing there? Okay, then. Fire cactus over there. Funny thing about Turbo Twister, and the reason why the AI uses it offensively, and that's because Turbo Twister actually dealt some incredible damage. Yeah, I already called Super Brainz maybe the most powerful zombie character. He used to be worse. It used to be that, like, Turbo Twister, over its duration, would deal like 170 damage. It was ridiculous. Pummeling awaits you, green-colored foes! Oh yes, I'm sure it does. Okay, they have a Forchwood over there. And he is definitely on his way. I thought he was gonna, like, go up that direction, but no, he's coming over here. Oh, really? No, that, no. That should be illegal. No, that should just... No. Like, whichever developer decided that Twin Champion Chomper was a good idea, just take your wish list and cross something off of it. This should be illegal. Okay. Let's go ahead and... Yep, jump. Shove a stink cloud in his face and run back to my allies. Oh god, scientists are getting hurt real bad. Okay, one Champion Chomper is dead. And actually, they're both dead, because I remember I killed the other one. Get rid of them. Do not attack our Mr. Electros. They're quite helpful. They zap all the little weeds and stuff. They're just so neat to have around. There we go. Come on. I can't even jump shot a Torchwood. I hit him with the 50 damage from the splash. This is pathetic. Oh, and he's going crazy now, gonna deal extra damage, and his dodges get hurt a whole lot more, and our scientist is dead. It just goes from bad to worse around here, doesn't it? Oh, I really want to get him up, I really want to get him up, I really want to get him. Thank you. Oh, and he immediately heals me. Thank you, thank you, thank you. There we go, I finally hit a ZPG on him. Perfect. Although I technically wasn't in the air, so it doesn't count as a jump shot. Here, up we go. Get rid of him. He spat a seed in my face. That's perfect. Yeah, do I look like an enemy? Do you need to missile madness me? And how did Super Brainz die? Our Super Brainz and our team died. Did he fall in the water? Okay, well, off to the Brainz Mobile we go.
Oi, okay, that was... Yeah, that went a little strangely.
Showed off some terrible performances there. But we did get through the mission. And I would call that an episode. But before you go, you should definitely consider subscribing and even liking the video. That would be quite helpful. Almost as helpful as the scientist healing you immediately after you res him. Which, fun fact, I'm not sure players can do because they can't actually activate abilities as players until they're completely back up. But if you res a scientist, then even in their resurrection animation, they're immediately healing you. I've always heard of the concept of, like, a dedicated healer, but, like, that's a whole new level, I have to say. But in any case, I will see you next time. We will finish off the other Super Brainz missions. Until then, have a good day.